Yes, I already know that everything is already precisely the way I really want it to be. Welcome to phase four practice, walking together in the wow. And if you enjoy phase four practice, you're going to love this one, because this is more advanced, actually, in a certain way. You could say that it is more advanced, which means what? It's more effective. If you can even say that. I mean, all the practices are effective, but this one carries an even greater punch to it. It gets closer, gets us a lot closer. And by the same token, it stretches us out, right? It's like a steeper hill to climb. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Okay, this is ultimately what we're getting at here. And we can practice this. Yes, I already know that this walkway is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that this tree is already, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I know that this day, yes, I already know that this day is already exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I already know that this world is already exactly the way that I want it to be. Okay, this is the practice. All right. And don't worry, we will help out with this practice. That's what it's all about. This practice is super, super effective. There's no question. I intuitively understand this. I can feel it. It's like, wow. So there'll be some wows here. There's already a wow. Like, are we really getting into this? Absolutely we are. We're in a hurry. That's right, we're in a big hurry. So we're getting into this. Yes, I already know that this plant is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that this air is all, yes, I already know that this air is all already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this sun is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, yes, I already know that this universe is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So keep in mind that phase four practice is training. We're in practice. All right, this is practice. It is not discussion, it's practice. It's not an absolute position, so to speak, word-wise. It's practice, okay? So we cannot mix non-practice with practice. Cannot do it. So when we're practicing, we're practicing. We don't drag in anything else. We have faith. This is a leap of faith. Yes, I already know that that house is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that that person is already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this practice is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this sickness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that this dying is, yes, I already know that this dying is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this trouble is already exactly the way I want it to be. Now, I've said that this is This is very advanced fourth phase practice, of course. But we deserve that, don't we? Absolutely. Anyone who has made the leap of faith into the fourth phase practice deserves the very best of that practice. Every single one. So then don't be surprised if you get the really good stuff. You are getting it. To take that leap of faith and to say, you know, I just believe the ego is fundamentally mistaken, and that's it. No more need to discuss any of that. Now we're just going to remind ourselves of what is true. To take that leap of faith, you deserve the very best of the four. So we get it. This is a jewel here that the Holy Spirit gave me this morning. In response to a dream where I was terrible dream, so stuck, just pathetic, it was just so horrible. And I said, how do I get out of this? This is terrible. Really? And the Holy Spirit says, okay, this may sound strange, but just try this out. And say, yes, I already know that this situation I'm in is already exactly the way I really want it to be. I said, wow. I never would have thought of saying this, right? As I'm looking at the situation, I'm saying, this is terrible. This isn't anything like I want anything to be. Everything about this is just opposite of what I really want. See, this is the situation I was in. In the dream, I said, oh my gosh. And the Holy Spirit is saying, yes, I already know that this situation, that everything about this situation is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Without any exception, exactly the way I really want it to be. I said, wow. Who would have ever thought to say something like this in this world, right? So right there we have this wow. Like this is just wow. That's all you can say. Who would ever think that, who would tell you practice like this, say this. This is what you need to say to believe. It's like so in working with this, I finally saw, oh, this is what it's really about. Oh, wow. I saw the aim of this practice. I saw what it's getting at. I said, oh, yeah. So this is why I'm presenting this via video, sharing it with Phase 4. Practitioners, as we walk together in the wow. This is why I'm sharing it, because I did see what it's getting at. I said, oh yeah, it's so tremendous that yeah, it's just so even though it sounds like nails on the chalkboard to us, right? Have faith that this is like extremely effective spiritual medicine for us. More than we can hardly realize. And this is why I had to work with this and look at it, and then I glimpsed it, and it's like, wow. So we will practice this way. And of course the wow will arise. Which is fine, because that's the way we practice, walking together in the wow. And we know this is no joke, because to say something like this, hey, you know, this, we can say this fatal disease, let's say someone has cancer, this I already know that this fatal disease is already exactly what I really want to be. Exactly what I really want. And you say, what? Or this situation I'm in. Yes, I already know that this situation I'm experiencing is already exactly how I want it to be. It's already exactly how I want it to be. Yes, I already know that this fatal cancer is already exactly how I want it to be. Yes, I already know this body is already exactly how I want it to be. Yes, I already know that these times are already exactly how I want them to be. Yes, I already know that this dust particle is already exactly how I want it to be. Yes, I already know that that river is already exactly how I want it to be. Yes, I already know that this misery is already exactly how I want it to be. Now, of course, this may be trying your credibility, right? But in phase four, we take a leap of faith. And we realize that the way that we've been looking at this, our situation, is fundamentally mistaken. Without any question, the ego is lying. We're deceiving. We're self-deceiving ourselves. So we don't go about it the egoic way anymore. We take a leap of faith and we practice as if we're already there. As if we're already there. So where is there? Where do we want to be? Exactly where we want to be. We want to be where everything is exactly the way we want it to be. Right? This is where we want to be. So we practice it. Yes, what else do we have to practice with? But what we believe we're experiencing. So yeah, I already know that nature is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Now there's additional explanation, okay, so we will get to that. We will get to it. In the meantime, we practice. So we get used to the practice. First step is to get used to the practice, to experience the wow, and understand the format. Get used to the format. Then we'll start catching glimpses of it. We don't want to catch glimpses of it before we're already familiar with the practice. Otherwise, we might go into analyzing and thinking, oh, I already got it. No, we're not trying to get it. We're trying to practice here. In our practicing, we will see what it is bringing us towards, and we'll say, oh, wow, that's great. But we don't stop our practicing just because we see it. The ego will say, see, you got it. You see where it's going. Okay, that's enough. Stop. That doesn't work. That doesn't work. Yes, I already know that my day is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my life has already been exactly the way that I want it to be. Yes, I already know that my future is already exactly the way that I want it to be. Exactly the way that I really want it to be. My future, I already know that my future is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that the future is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything will always be exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that already everything will always be exactly the way I really want it to be. So our first step here is to practice being able to say this. And since we have made a leap of faith and we're practicing as if, we realize, okay, we're practicing this as if. This. But of course, this is so diametrically opposite of what we've been trained by the ego, our own self-training and self-deception is diametrically opposite, isn't it? So we just said, wow, I'm not used to this. I'm not used to thinking this way. So this brings up this wow feeling where you say, okay, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I already know that this cat is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this climate, today's climate, is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this neighborhood is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know this community is already exactly the way that I want it to be. Yes, I already know that my friends are already exactly the way I want them to be. Yes, I already know that my enemies are already exactly the way I want them to be. Yes, I already know that all the troublemakers are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all the circumstances of my life are already exactly the way I really want them to be. What is this really? It's empowerment. I mean, we're going to, but you see, we can't even say it's empowerment. This is where words trick us, which is why practices works and analytics don't work. So we continue to practice and feel the wow. Because the wow is we know we can feel the empowerment this is bringing us, right? We feel it. But to say the word empowerment damns it with faint praise. You see, it damns it with faint praise and confuses us. So we're not really saying that. We're practicing. So I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that every win is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everywhere is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this fear is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this trouble is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this place is already exactly the way I really want it to be. If we have this wow reaction, find it. I am not a body. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So very fortunate are the ones that have gotten to this video, come across this video. Very fortunate. Yes, I already know that this fortune, that my fortune, is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my feeling is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my experiencing is already exactly the way I really want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So we are introducing this practice slowly here. We're taking it easy and slow, okay? We're not jumping to any conclusions yet, okay? Because this one is so important. This practice, getting this practice in your arsenal of practice, that you have it in your deck of practice cards, you know, is super important. So you can go to it like that. Tremendously important. So of course we're just easing into this. Well, actually we're going into it really strongly, but we're also taking it easy. Make haste slowly. A wonderful phrase. Let's make haste slowly. Yeah, we're making haste, but we're making haste slowlier. Yes, I already know that my life is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everyone's life is already exactly the way, which I say they want it to be, or I want it to, I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everyone's life is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that everyone's actions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that everyone's attitudes are already exactly the way I really want them to be. So the first step is we prove to ourselves that we can do this. You see, the ego is telling us that it's impossible. We can't practice. We're absolutely impossible. Especially this one. It's impossible. You can't do it. It's so insane. It's impossible for you to do it. Okay. Well, we're proving that we can do it. So we've already proved that, once again, the ego is completely mistaken. Utterly mistaken, and not worth even engaging in any dialogue whatsoever with that which is so completely cuckoo. All right, forget it. No point to that, no purpose at all. So, and we could say, yes, I already know that the ego is already exactly the way I really want it to be. All right, okay, that's all we need to say about the ego. Yes, I already know that the ego is already exactly the way I want it to be. So we're not struggling with the ego, fighting with the ego, doing anything with the ego. Yes, I already know that the ego is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all delusion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So, of course, we're spiritual marines here, right? When you go into phase four, you're a spiritual marine. And so when the marine battalion commander says, okay, this is our mission is to take this beach, is to take this, okay, this is our mission. We don't argue about it, because we say, okay, this is our mission. Take, okay, we're going to take this beach. In fact, the beach is already taken. There's no doubt that we're going to take the beach. It's already done. In our minds, it's already done. It's already done. This is the mindset of a spiritual marine. So we're going to do this practice. It's already done. Done deal. And yes, I already know that I've already done it. See, it's like that. So we don't think, oh, this is difficult, you complain. That's not a spiritual marine. A spiritual marine stands their ground and says, okay, this is what the orders are. We know that the commander knows what they're doing. So this is what needs to be done. So it's a done deal. Because spiritual marines already know they've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that I'm already enlightened. I already know I've already succeeded. We're just reenacting the success, actually. Just a reenactment. Out of honor to our creativity, we're just reenacting the success here, but we've already succeeded. So yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all self-delusion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all entrapment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all hellishness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all torment is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So you see, do we feel defeated? Do we feel... No, I'm saying like, wow. I'm feeling like, wow. This positive wow, like, wow. I can say this, I can think this, I can believe, wow. And I can feel the potential. You can feel like, oh, wow, we're moving into some beautiful country here or something. Yeah, wow. Yes, I already know that all the land is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all the mountains are already exactly the way I want them to be. Yes, I already know that all the landscapes are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all this vegetation is exactly the way I really want it to be. So we don't want to short-circuit this by trying to be too smart about it. So remember, it's the practice that's important, not the conclusion. The conclusion will automatically reveal itself once we've done the practice. We don't need to try and grab a hold of the conclusion. We can glimpse it and say, okay, it's nice, and then go back to practicing. Which is what I've done this morning. I saw it. I said, oh, yeah, I see what this is getting at. Fine. So I'm very motivated to practice this. Very motivated to practice this. So yes, I already know that everything is already exactly where, exactly how I really want it to be. Exactly how I really want it to be. I know that everything is exactly the way I really want it to be. The way I really want it to be. Exactly the way I really desire it to be. Yes, I already know that everything is exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that all the animals are... Yes, I already know that all the animals are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all the insects are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all the atoms are already exactly the way I want them to be. And yes, I already know that all the molecules are already exactly the way I want them to be. And yes, I already know that all the elements are already exactly the way I really want them to be. And yes, I already know that all the material is already exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I already know that all matter is already exactly the way that I want it, really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all time is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all space is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Now the intensity of this is starting to affect my voice. I'm starting to be almost unable to speak. So, little folks, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So the wow of this is so strong that it's affecting my capacity to breathe or to speak. Probably a good time to full stop in the wow here. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So, yes, I already know that this obstruction is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this trouble is already exactly the way that I want it to be. In fact, yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way that I want it to be. So, we don't want to rush this one. Okay, this is what I'm seeing. Okay, fine. We're not quite at a phase, but we can just, you know, drive this one through and repeat. That'll come later. Soon. This is so potent that we need to first just ease into it. I recall, remember when I first started this phase four and around the 1st of January. As I got going, the 8th of January, I came down with this terrible illness. Because there's just the resistance. And I've had to gradually work through it. And now when I'm doing this particular exercise, it's trying to come back on me. Because this is the resistance. You know, it's shock. It's shock, really. Deep shock. So, yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that this shock is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this shock is already exactly the way I really want it to be. You see, no struggle. No struggle with anything. Yes, I already know that this fatigue is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this fatigue is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Now, those of you who are phase fours, spiritual marines, phase four, intuitively you know, intuitively you can feel it's like, wow, we've just hooked a whale. You know, we're fishing and we just realize we've just landed a whale on the end of the line there. We say, yes, I already know that landing a whale is already exactly what I really want to be. Exactly the way I want it to be. Yes, I already know that hooking this whale is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Landing this whale. Yes, I already know that this struggle is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So, yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I want it to be. So we're getting used to the form of this here, the practicing, the format. Yes, I already know that this car is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this road is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Now, of course, phase 0, 1, 2, and 3, they can't tolerate this. They can't tolerate it. But phase 4 is a different story. Because this is the leap of faith where we're saying as if it were. As if it already is. And we know there's a deep wisdom to this. We've seen that there's a deep truth to this, deeper than it's the deepest. You know, there's absolute truth to this. Because what is it that we really want everything to be? The way that we want everything to really be, what is that? Well, we want it to be included in the oneness, is what we really want. That's it. Because if it's already included in the oneness, there's nothing we need to do. There is no struggle, actually. It's only because we believe it is not included in the oneness that we feel a sense of struggle, separation, guilt, trouble, misery, all that. See, all of that. The delusion we're in is that all this stuff is not included in the oneness. We have to somehow do something to bring it into the oneness. So we think there's something fundamentally wrong with everything. So all we're saying is, no, there's something fundamentally right with everything. In fact, everything is already exactly the way I already want it. I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. It's already included in the oneness. Okay. So this is intuitively we feel, okay, wow. Yes, I already know that this kitchen is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this food is already exactly the way I really want it to be. See, I really want it to be is the key phrase. Exactly. Yes, I already know. That's all important. The whole way this is structured is very important. Yes, I already know that this food is already, meaning nothing needs to change or take place. It's already exactly the way I really want it to be. I really want it to be. We're not saying the way I want it to be, the way I really want it to be. And what do I really want this food to be? I want it to already be. I want it to already be included in all that is, the oneness. So I don't have to do anything. See? So that I'm free of doing. See, absolute freedom is not involved in doing anything. It's involved in being, experiencing its absolute freedom. So to think that we have to do something is like hell for us. It's like, what? It's terrible imprisonment. And to think that we have to get something that back into the oneness means that somehow it got out of the oneness somehow. And then we say, how did that happen? You see, how did, and then we're lost in egoic misery. Thinking, conceptualizing, how did that happen? So the way we really want it to be is that it's already exactly the way I really want it to be. It's already that. Okay, so now we're filling this out. Yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this year is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this the history of this world is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that the history of this universe is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that everything in this universe is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So it's an absolute blessing to be able to practice this way, thanks to the inspiration for this, which comes from me, it's been a combination of Jesus Christ and Longchenpa. Jesus Christ supplied the bulk of the material here. Longchenpa came in like a catalyst. You know, you put catalyst, a few drops, and catalyze it. That really helps the reaction, right? It helps the prod something take place. This is how it happened, has happened for me. I was stuck. I know that Jesus has the answer, but I couldn't get to practicing it until Longchenpa came into the picture, into my awareness, and somehow he was able to catalyze it, so I actually started practicing. So it's a combination of their efforts, along with the several examples that proved that these efforts do work, and we can be in the world having the effectiveness of these efforts, experiencing the effectiveness of these efforts, we can still function in the world, you see. And those two, Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi and Bhagavani Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, those two examples, looking at those examples, I said, hey, you still can function here in this world. Realizing that everything is already exactly the way you really want it to be. You can still function here, and you can be very helpful to others. So those examples are extremely helpful. So it's a cooperative effort among those four, as I put it. But as far as the practicing, we're going to just narrow it down to Jesus and Longchenpa. Those two are the instrumentally helpful. Jesus, as we know, supremely clear and wise and all-knowing, super pragmatic, has the absolute pragmatism of what will work. You know, with Longchenpa being, you know, super great practicer, spending his entire life, you know, in caves, in retreats, practicing, you know, just the ultimate in discipline and practice and successful practice and clarity and all of that. So come in and say, don't worry, you know, you can do it. Somehow bringing that compassion of practice, say, yeah, don't worry, go ahead, go for it. After, don't worry, we'll back you up. So these practices face are supremely wonderful practices, supremely effective practices, suitable for our age and our situation here, okay? Suitable for it. So there's pragmatic genius behind it and tremendous compassion behind it. So yes, I already know that all is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that leaf is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that bird is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that shadow is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that pine cone is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that debris is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that those flowers are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that these sounds are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that my experiencing is already exactly the way I want it to be. So remember the posture, holding yourself steady. Just simply, the best way to look at it is simply not slouching. Instead of trying to say, well, I need to do this. No, just don't slouch, that's all. And so, okay, I'm not slouching, everything's fine. Same way with the practice, the tenor of the practice, don't be goofy about it. As long as you're not being goofy, it's fine. That's a much better way to do it than to say, well, you need to have this way, and then you're thinking. No, all you have to do is, am I being goofy, goofing up? No, okay, then I'm fine. Am I slouching? No, then I'm fine. Just like that, just easily like that. Am I just sitting here? Yeah, okay, fine. It's great, everything's fine then. You gotta watch it with the goofiness. When I get tired, I start to get goofy. You know, saying it like in a funny voice, or trying to be humorous about it, or just making suddenly burst out in song, or make a joke. You start getting goofy, you start getting silly. So as long as you don't get silly, get goofy about it. It's right on track. So yes, I already know that all struggles are already exactly the way that I really want them to be. I may have left out the term really in a few previous ones. I don't know if it was possible, but it should be in there. It's important to put that in there. So yes, I already know that bird is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that those shadows are already exactly the way that I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that how I feel is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my appearance is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all appearance is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So this practice is very easy, right? You just sit still, don't slouch, and don't be silly, or don't be goofy. You can think about it, but don't do it. And in fact, since you're not going to do it, there's no purpose of thinking about it. You see, the phase 1, 2, or 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, they can't figure it out because they're saying, yeah, but, how do I do the form correctly? How do I do it correctly? How do I sit correctly? How do I do it? Because they feel they can't do the practice correctly, the content. So they kind of compensate. But see, here, we can do the content here. So the other stuff is just minimal concern. Am I slouching? No, okay, fine. Am I being goofy? No, okay, fine. End of concern. Am I sitting quietly here? Yes, okay, fine. End of concern. Yes, I already know that all my frustration is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all my temptation is exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all my concerns are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all my fears are already exactly the way I really want them to be. We cannot explain the fourth phase, the third phase. All we can say is that it is possible by continuing on in the third one phase, one, two, and three, that as you continue on, that eventually you can get the help you need to make the leap of faith into the fourth phase. That's all we can say. We can't explain it to you. We cannot convince you to do it. We can't do anything about it. But we do know that your determination to keep disciplining yourself, keep working at spiritual truth, keep disciplining yourself, keep trying, brings in the necessary catalyst that will help you actually get started, which is what happened with me. This long jumper showed up, and again, I had no idea who it was, but I made this just great prayer. I said, I'm stuck, and the world's stuck. In this world, our spirituality is stuck, we're stalled out. And I said, if there's anyone that can help us, who actually can help us, and is willing to do so, I said, please help us right now, immediately. We are so stuck. This is so severe. Please help us out right now. And of course, I can say now, practicing, yes, I already know that all stuckness, yes, I already know that all stuckness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all stuckness is already exactly the way I want it to be. Okay. But this is a different context as we're practicing. We're in phase four practice, different context. And I made this prayer, and it was really, I sent it all directions. I said, no restrictions. Who responds? I have no restrictions, only someone who actually can help and is willing to help. Then I will accept your help. This is what I said, I will accept your help. I don't care what your name is, what you're from, what your history, whatever. None of that, no qualifications matter, except that you actually can help and actually will help. You see? That's it. And the very next night, in dreaming, this man figure, showed up in my dream from beyond the sea. I saw him walking across the vast sea, walking on the water, as it were, across the sea. He's walking on top of the sea. And from beyond, he came from beyond the sea. And the scene, he did not fall down into the scene even. I said, who is it that can walk on water like this across the sea, from beyond the sea, and then came to the shore? And I said, wow, who is this? What is this? Then I asked him a question. I said, how was the sea? And he said, I said, was it hot or was it cold? He said, it was both. It was both. And I said, it's both. And I said, wow. Who is this? And I said, and it had a red cross, a lifeguard tank top and a red cross on it, meaning lifesaver. Lifesaver. Medic, battlefield medic, lifesaver. Willing to go on the battlefield. What do medics do? They're willing to go on the battlefield under fire and drag their wounded comrades out of the battlefield and evacuate them to hospital, field hospital, so they can be sick, their lives can be saved. That's what medics do. I mean, you talk about heroes. It's the medics, They've got a red cross on it, it says medic. And they're not, but they're going in, people are, bullets are flying everywhere, bombs are bursting everywhere. It's not like automatically they're immune because they got, they're taking this, they're willing to go into the battlefield like this to help out their, fallen comrades. So here is somebody who shows up willing to help us out here on the battlefield of delusion. So I said, wow. I had no idea who it was. I had no idea. But I realized that somebody had shown up. Someone answered my prayer. Someone had answered my prayer. Wow. Thank you. I don't really care what your name is or whatever, you know. Welcome, 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 welcome. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So, turned out to be this catalyst, which was able to catalyze my practicing, you see. Well, this is the result of going through phase 1, 2, and 3 and really maturing the belief that, you know, it is possible. Somehow it's possible. I don't know how, but somehow I know it's possible. So I'm going to keep on trying to get myself ready. This is what we do on the spiritual path. We say, I know somehow freedom is possible. I know, I trust and believe that there are those who have been freed from some misery. And I trust and believe, I know it's possible, but I don't know how. But why? Because we're still under the sway of the ego's logic. We still aren't willing to say that the ego's fundamentally, totally, without any question, mistaken. We're still afraid to do that because the ego tells us that it's impossible for the ego to leave us. That if we do this practice, one practice, we can't do, otherwise the ego will leave us. Therefore, it's impossible for us to do the practice. We're still sort of bamboozled by this logic. Yeah. But if we just get to the point where we just say, look, this logic is fundamentally mistaken. There's nothing else to say about it. It's just wrong. We can then take a leap of faith. It seems to be a leap of faith. And start practicing as if truth is already true. 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 But I will say that I believe a boost is necessary. This is why for several years I talked about the big boost. I said, the big boost is here. It's coming. This big boost is going to come. Well, it did come. It already happened. The big boost for me already happened. And not just for me, but I feel that this big boost is going to spread to others. And it was, in this instance, what we call historically the name Longchenpa refers to someone who was in this world at some point. In Tibet, who was able to practice and completely free themselves from delusion. Yeah. And so it refers to one who's truly liberated, who's truly beyond the sea, even beyond seeing, even beyond perception. Before Longchenpa passed away into Parinirvana, he said he's going to the land of the boundless, what, deathlessness. Yeah, that's where he's going. I mean, he's beyond the sea. Total, complete fulfillment, you know. All continuity issues vanished without a trace for him. Yeah, this is a very helpful being. This is a very helpful being. And so this happened to be what gave the boost to me. As I say, Jesus Christ laid all the groundwork. Did the hard part. He did the hard part. He did laying all this groundwork, getting me yelling at him, saying he's mistaken, he's persecuting me. You know, Jesus Christ is willing to lay out all the groundwork of, you know, phase 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, like that. And then also 4, but do all that, tough work where we're hating on him and saying, hey, I can't do this, you're crazy, and stuff. He did all that, the hard part, okay, that's fine. But still, a catalyst, a boost is needed, a catalyst is needed. See, this is the way that I see it working. Because, it's like you have so much history with Jesus Christ, and we're like, taking this leap of faith is so difficult. In a sort of fresh perspective, fresh eyes, fresh, and it catalyzes and realizes, hey, Jesus is telling me right. These practices are right. This is the way. And you start practicing, you see. So in hindsight, this is how I've experienced it. This is how I've experienced it working. I knew I was stuck. This is why I kept saying, but I also knew a big boost was coming. So intuitively I knew a big boost. I try to put up, some, you know, the internet. I keep trying to push this. The big boost is here, or it's coming. Act as if it's here. I try to act as if it's already here. I know. Yes, I already know the big boost is already here. You know, this is what I tried to do, and it worked. It worked because by doing this, I got ready for it as if it's already happened. And then when it came, I was just like, yeah, this is what I'm expecting. Yeah, I'm expecting this to already, it's already happened. And so this is just like, well, like a reenactment of it or something, fine. And it helps you. It's super helpful to act as if it's already happened. It's already here. It's already here. Yes, I already know the big boost is already here. And then it did come. It did come. I know. Anyway, without spinning off in too many ways here, we're just kind of cooling down in the wow of this practice, this awesome practice. To have the capability to do this practice is simply awesome. Now, this is a practice that Jesus Christ in Longchamp will tell you is an awesome practice. Awesomely successful practice. And we have it. And we're doing it. And so, a little bird just showed up here and looked at me like, huh? Hey, I already know that I am exactly the way I really want to be. Hey, I already know that I'm exactly the way I really want to be. This little bird showed up right in front of me on the ground. It's looking for something. And it suddenly looked up at me and it, like, sideways, it saw me. And it kind of eyes went, whoop. And like, wow, like that. This one. All right, somebody forgot a password. You know, there's so many passwords. Isn't this terrible? Yes, I already know that all this terribleness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this terrible world is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this terrible complexity of life is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So people might ask, is this Christianity? Is this Dzogchen? No, it's phase four practice. It's walking together in the wow is what it is. It's walking together in the wow of phase four practice. That's what it is. We're not trying to put new wine into old wineskins. However much everybody says, oh, sure, yeah, you can do that. You know, well, we're not doing that. This is a collaborative effort. This is a collaborative effort. This is very significant. It's a collaborative effort that I've experienced between Jesus Christ and Longchenpa. Okay, it's a collaborative effort. And it's walking together in the wow of phase four practice. This is very clear delineation, okay? That understanding now of phase one, two, and three and how it goes in hindsight, and I realize that as Jesus says, a leap of faith into practicing as if is what's ultimately required. This is what Jesus has said. Ultimately, he says you have to do this leap of faith, and we've done it. We're doing it. Okay, so we're done. Now we're practicing this in this, and this is very advanced. It's phase four. Phase four leads to what? We call it the fifth state or five beyond. I would say that phase five. Well, we won't even say, but we will experience it. Phase four leads to experiencing what is beyond phase four. Let's put it that way. And you can say it's five. I left a little hand up there on the graphic on the website. ClaryRoss.YolaSite.com. This little hand there, five fingers. You know, behind this practice is five. What is five? Well, we'll just say it's what we're going to get to experience. Is what we're going to get to experience. Vision of oneness. All right, let's put it that way. The vision of oneness. We will get there. We don't need to speculate because we know we're getting there. The other phases before this, spend too much time speculating. Well, so what's that like? What's that like? Waste time. You know, ultimately those other phases, wasting time. Delay. Terrible. Very tough. So the more of those who are doing phase four practicing and then experiencing the fruits of that, which we'll call fiveness, experiencing the fruits of fiveness, maybe waving bye-bye to all delusion, waving bye-bye to delusion. One moment. The more of us that do this, the easier it is for others. Easier it is for others, for sure. Because it filters through a culture. It filters through it. It makes it easier for everyone, actually. Alright, you get some punches of interruption, just roll with them. Doesn't matter, just roll with them. You say, yes, I already know. That these interruptions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that these interruptions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. So you see, with this practice, everything is grist for the mill. It's all grist for the mill. Oh, I'm upset. Oh, great. Yes, I already practiced. Yes, I already know that this upset is already exactly the way I really want it to be. See? See, the glass is always half full now, isn't it? The glass is always half full now. This tragedy, oh, yes, I already know that this tragedy is already exactly the way I really want it to be. These troubles, yes, I already know these troubles are already exactly the way I want them to, exactly the way I really want them to be. Keep that really in there, the way I really want them to be. Emphasize, really want it. So yes, I already know that these interruptions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. This hunger, yes, I already know that this hunger is already the way I really want it to be. Yeah. This poverty, yes, I already know that this poverty is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So, perfect practice, isn't it? A glass always half full, wherever we go. This traffic, yes, I already know that this traffic is already exactly the way I really want it to be. You're driving in, you know, terrible rush hour traffic. You say, hey, wait a minute. This is great, time to practice. Yes, I already know that this terrible traffic is already exactly the way I really want it to be. This pollution is polluted. Yes, I already know that this pollution is already exactly where I really want it to be. This boredom. Yes, I already know that this boredom is already exactly the way I really want it to be. And you see, as soon as you're practicing like this, are you still bored? You're not bored anymore, are you? You're not suffering from the traffic. You're saying, wow, this is fantastic. I love this practice. Glass is half full for sure. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that this bureaucracy is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that politics is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all this social engineering is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that these judgments are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this point of view is already exactly the way I really want it to be. See, if somebody says something just like, say, oh great, time to practice. Yes, I already know that this viewpoint is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that impermanence is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that impermanence is already exactly the way I really want it to be. See, so our cup is always half full now, for sure. Now, I know that we know that first, second, or third phase, for instance, Christians might be saying, yeah, you can't do this. What do you mean? And then first and second, third phase Buddhists are they're saying, you can't do this. You can't have Jesus Christ and Longchenpa working together. You can't do that. And it's the ego saying, you can't do this. It's impossible to do this practice. It's impossible. That's really what they're saying. They're just packaging it very religiously, saying, no, Jesus says you can't do this. Our tradition about Jesus says you can't do this. Our tradition about Buddha says you can't do this, or whatever. They're just packaging it in religious frocks and garb, whatever, and religious bows and ribbons, which is the ego saying, is the ego's logic. They're still in the sway of the ego's logic, saying, you can't, it's impossible to practice. That's why you can't do it. Because again, the ego's logic is what? The ego says, it's impossible that I can ever leave you. I can never leave you. It's impossible I can ever leave you. If you do this one practice, this as if, right, practice, I'm going to leave you. Therefore, it's impossible that you can do this practice. It's impossible. You can't do this practice. Impossible. This is the ego's logic. The ego says, it's impossible that I ever leave you. If you do this practice, I'll leave you. Therefore, it's impossible that for you to do this practice. And if we keep accepting this logic, you know, then we have to compensate for not doing this practice, for still being insane, you know, insanity, feeling fear, and like, oh my gosh, I'm so burdened. And so we have to somehow rationalize it to ourselves that we're saying it's impossible to do this practice. So we say, well, Jesus told me I can't do this practice, or Buddha told me I can't do this practice, or, you know, Longchenpa told me I can't do this practice, or, yeah, no, they said I can never do this practice, like, and this is what happens. They get all righteous, and say, no, you can't do it. They can't do it. That's the price we pay for believing in the ego's malevolent illogic. Yeah, which is only our own self-deception, which is ultimately us trying to trick God into believing in time, really. Because we say, hey God, we're believing in it. We know it's real, so you're missing out on reality, an aspect of reality, God. You've got to experience time too, God. See, this is what we're doing. We're trying to deceive ourselves. Trying to trick God. We're trying to make ourselves greater than God by making God lesser than we are. And the way we want to make God lesser than we are is to make God believe that time is real. Okay, so we imagine that time is real, and we believe we can convince God by convincing ourselves first. And then God will say, oh, well, I created spirit exactly like me, and if spirit believes in time, says it's real, then I must believe it's real too. It must be real. You see, this is what we're trying to do. And we're so creative at this deception. Our creativity is so, unbelievably believable. we have done this immensely elaborate and detailed mirage, delusion, that makes it seem like time is real, okay? Even though doesn't exist, never existed. It's never existed. But it certainly, we've put on quite a magic show. Yeah. So we're believing our own magic show is what the problem is. So of course, phase 1, 2, and 3, you know, we're struggling. We're saying, yeah, are you saying this magic show isn't real? I don't know. It sure looks convincing to me. And gradually they say, well, maybe, I'm not sure, maybe it's not so convincing. And it takes quite a while to gradually wear away our continuity fear. It's like, wow, what if it wasn't real? Oh boy, it's scary. I'm scared. Gradually wear it away, and then we get to the point eventually when we get a big boost, and we're able to actually start practicing what the ego tells us we can never practice. And we're no longer worried about ecumenical help whatsoever. Because remember, reality is even beyond the seeing of reality, right? Reality doesn't need to be seen. And all is one. All is one. All is already one. So absolutely, ecumenicalness can and does happen when we're talking about phase four. Phase four is a whole different fish, you know, is a whale. It's not a fish, it's a whale. And yeah, see, even though the whale swims in the sea, it breathes the air. You see, it breathes air and it can jump out of the sea, it breathes air. Everybody thinks, well, it's a big fish. No, it's not, it's actually a big mammal. So phase four practice isn't just another fish, it's something different altogether. It is an as if we are already free. As if we need do nothing. As if we already need do nothing. And from this standpoint, history, tradition, names, forms, all that stuff is out the window. It's already out the window. It already means nothing. Because we're not blending traditions here at all. We're doing phase four, walking together in the wow. This isn't the Christian tradition. This is not the Buddhist tradition. This is not either tradition, actually. This simply is what it is. And so it is simply phase four, walking together in the wow, right here, right now, designed for right here, right now. So we have our own tradition right here and right now, actually. And we're not trying to put this new wine into old wineskins as much as people insist on it. No, we will not. So, if they want to stew in it, let them stew in it. Hopefully, they get the big boost themselves. You know, maybe someone in the Buddhist tradition or some other tradition, they might make a prayer for help, and someone turns up and they don't know who that is. And later on they'll find out, oh, it was Jesus Christ that showed up. You see, that can happen too. I don't know. Sure it can. There's no reason why it cannot when we're talking about phase four. Now, when we're talking about phase one, two, and three, I believe it is better to stay within your tradition. Okay? Stay within your tradition. Don't mess around with too much ecumenicalism in phase one, two, and three. But truly, just as radical Sakchin really is like a phase four in that it transcends Buddhism, it transcends tradition. It really does, see, it's like that. But Buddhists think, well, it's Buddhism. Not really, not really, not really, you see. See, like Longchenpa is not really a Buddhist teacher, not really. Because the message transcends the message. It is already completely ecumenical, actually. But we're not even trying to put it into the wine of Dzogchen at all, actually. We're using our own terminology, and the terminology here is one of practice. Practice is the terminology. Okay, people want us to give different terminology. No, there isn't any other terminology, really. We can use a little bit, but ultimately and essentially, the terminology of phase four is the terminology of the practice. That's what it is. not all the commentary on the practice. That's just, those are trifles. Those are side issues. Side lights. It's the practice itself. So yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. That is the terminology. This is the terminology. You don't write a, well, you don't, so to say, you can write a book, but you don't write a book on phase four. You practice phase four. Now, it's possible that a book could be written to introduce phase four and to clarify, etc., just straight out. But that's not the purpose. The real purpose of phase four is the actual practice. The real words of phase four are the actual practice. Yes, and yeah, yes. All right, that's finally yes. I already know. I know. Yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. That is the teaching of phase four. Hey, you meet phase four. You meet Jesus, for instance, or Longchenpa, and you say, "Hi, hey, great. Yes, I already know that you're exactly the way. You're already exactly the way I really want you to be." And you say, "Yes, hi. I already know that you are already exactly the way I really want you to be." Like that, you know, that would almost be like the talk, you know. Wow, isn't this day? Isn't everything already exactly the way we really want it to be? Isn't this wonderful? Hey, I already know that this wonderfulness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this sound, this bird call, is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So, the simple way into this practice, just like a tree, for instance. Yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this tree is exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes. Now this yes is like, of course, yes. And you're acknowledging, yes, I do, I already know this. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. You're owning it. You say, "I already own this. This is already acceptable to me." Yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I really want it to be. No judgments necessary whatsoever. I already know. See, no judgments necessary. Yes, I already know that that wall is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this light is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this light is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this ambience is already exactly the way I really want it to be. again, phase four is not pressed upon those who are in phase one, two, or three, especially if they're in a monastic culture setting where this is the culture, a religious focus is the culture. We must not press phase four upon them. Okay, this is the whole Samaya secrecy to that in Buddhism, because it was a monastic culture and still is. It's not right to press it upon them, because they will conflate it, they will write books about it, they will try to understand it, compensate for their lack of not doing it by trying to compensate in some way, and it'll slow their spiritual progress down. But in this wide open wild wild west situation where everybody's free to do their own thing and there's no, you know, we just put it out there. It's like a buffet table. I mean, basically the modern world is like a spiritual buffet table. You put it out on the buffet and people can say, am I ready for that? No, I don't think I'm quite ready for that. Okay. But you can't go into, for instance, a Catholic church and say, hey, everybody, okay, I've got this great teaching for you, and this is what you need to do, and so, okay, you got to start doing this. You can't do that. You can't do that. You can't get up there as a priest and profess this to the congregation. You can't do that. You can do it, but it's a mistake. Highly advised, ill-advised, you know. Because they feel they're a captive audience in a tradition in that situation. So they will feel obligated to try to do it. So nobody should feel obligated that they have to try and do this. This comes about internally when you get a big boost from within and you actually start doing it. You realize, yeah, I can do this. In fact, I am doing it. I'm already doing it. And it becomes gradually acceptable to you. It took me, you know, a little over a year. Oh my gosh, little bird is here. Hi, bird. Looking for some potential nest, probably. It took me about 13 months or so from the point I got the big boost from Monjempa to when I actually started fourth phase practice. I already know, you know, this practice. So let's say just around it, it's about a year of starting to practice, getting momentum towards the real effective practice, as if, I already know, you know, gaining speed up to that point. So the danger is if someone's in a monastic culture and they feel obligated that they need to do this, especially if they're in a culture that cultivates spiritual cities or powers, then it's very dangerous. Fortunately, in our culture, we don't do that. In the traditions like Christianity, this is a very good tradition in that we stay away from all sorts of psychic power, special powers, all this stuff. No, stay away from that. That's very, very helpful to stay away from all that. If you're in a culture where that is all sorts of magicians or manipulating energy and stuff, then their arrogance, they can feel like, hey, maybe I can get even greater powers through doing this. And so they'll try to force themselves to do it. They'll try to force themselves thinking that they can get even more powerful magic. And then that can cause all sorts of overcompensations in them. It's not advisable. But here in the West, for the most part, here in the world, the most part of the world now, a lot of people realize, you know, don't waste your time on that silliness. Let's get to what's really important. And Christian tradition is a very good one, in that it absolutely de-emphasizes those type of powers. It says, basically says, let Jesus do that. But you can't do that. You can't. You could, but you can't. Meaning, as long as you're in this tradition, we're not expecting that of you at all. We're not expecting any of this stuff of you. Okay. So that's very good first phase teaching, second phase teaching, and even somewhat third phase teaching. It's very helpful. Because I said, we're not expecting any of this, what Jesus did, we're not expecting any of this from you whatsoever within this tradition of teaching. Now, ultimately, of course, all miracles are equally easy. There's no degree of difficulty among any quote-unquote miracles, because it's not any actually miracle at all. Nothing's, it just, it, no quote-unquote laws of nature being violated, because there aren't any real laws of nature. You see, we're absolutely free. So if we want to walk on water, have this appearance, then this is what it appears as. But these things are not our goal at all. I never, in my mind, I never think of that as any sort of goal at all. So, certainly there's less of a temptation in the world. Now, there's always some who are into magic, you know, black magic, white magic is all the same. Magic, trying to manipulate this illusion we call energy, electromagnetism, and they can and will get into trouble no matter what, no matter what, unfortunately. But this teaching here is just simple, simple, and doesn't lend itself to much abuse at all, really. Now, for us, it's a strain. It can bring a strain, absolutely. It is a strain, and that can manifest in some ways, for sure. Each one has to monitor their own situation. Each one is responsible for their own situation, for their own pacing. And if they cannot do it certainly naturally and easily, then don't force it. The leap of faith hasn't been taken yet. You're still trying to make a deal with the ego. The ego says, well, we say, well, let's make a deal. I'll do some of what you say, but also I want to do this. And the ego say, okay, well, as long as you use this to do more powerful magic, then okay, you know, that kind of thing. That's not the way. You have to just take a leap of faith and say, the ego, I'm finished with the ego. It's fundamentally, totally, totally mistaken. Intrinsically mistaken, and there's nothing I can do about that. So it's over. I'm taking a leap of faith, and now I'm simply reminding myself of what I am, actually. No deals with the ego. So yes, I already know that everything is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all this complexity is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that all these difficulties are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all these blockages are already exactly the way that I really want them to be. So, our glass is always half full. It is always half full. And that's all. It's that simple. So we can always practice. Yes, I already know that these demands are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this unpleasantness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Now, in my life, I always tried to do this, except I still felt I needed to help the ego out or make a could deal with the ego, so it wasn't effective. I have a little trouble. There we go, a little better. It wasn't effective. So I was trying to do this and still please the ego. You know, say, hey, ego, see, you know, does this please you? You know, is it, see, look at this. I'm still engaging. So it didn't work. So I had a very difficult time in life because in all circumstances, I was trying to do this practice, but not quite doing it. And so you feel like stuck. You feel stuck. Like in a limbo, you feel stuck. It's very difficult to do this practice in this world, the way the belief systems of this world are. You feel that you have to make a deal with the ego. You know, see, this is the problem. But we now, leap of faith, realize we don't need to make any deal with the ego. The ego's completely mistaken. There's no need to make, we don't have any need to make any deal whatsoever. We're finished. In fact, we're already finished with the ego. Yes, I already know that I'm already finished with the ego. Yes, I already know that I'm already completely done with the ego. Yes, I already know that I'm already irreversibly free of the ego. Yes, I already know that I'm already irreversibly free of the ego. So yes, I already know that that siren is already exactly what I really want to, exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that that siren is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that these aches, body aches, are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this uncertainty is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So we keep these practices very simple. That's all that's needed. Those who want to try and gain some power of magic, making themselves look beautiful, alluring, attractive, or, you know, all this different ways they try to use magic and all that stuff. That they'll always want, say, wait a minute, I want more explanation. I can't, it'll be like that for them. No. But for us, no, we don't need any of that. We just practice, that's all. Because we already feel the attraction to what this practice is leading us to. It's already part of it. That's all we need. So yes, I already know that this practice is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this day is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that these trials and tribulations are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this life is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that these troubles are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that this upset is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So you see, we're always half full. We're always one up on whatever happens. We're already one up. Yes, I already know that all these happenings are already exactly the way I want them to be. Yes, I already know that these pressures are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that these failures are already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that this helplessness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this hopelessness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Now, it took me about a year of practicing similar practices, some of the precursors, so that I could get ready eventually, so I'm able to now help share this practice with the world. So it took me about a year of precursor practicing, to be able to get to this really effective practice. This is super effective practice. And before, I just didn't have the will to be able to say this. Didn't have the will. So I kind of approximated it, got close to it, approximated, which is part of the deal, you know, in, you know, high third phase, transitioning from third to fourth phase, you start approximating fourth phase practice. This is a transitional phase. So for about a year, I was transitional phase into at least the final transitional phase. I was probably doing other transitional phases before that, actually. But then the last transitional phase into fourth phase practice was approximating close to this practice, but not quite it. But now this is the real deal now. So yes, I already know that this hopelessness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this noise is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this commotion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this confusion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this confusion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So a year ago, I couldn't do this practice. See, a year ago, I couldn't have done it. Even though I was aware that something like this is possible and advisable, couldn't do it. Now I'm able to do it. So it took some gearing up, to get to this. We can say this: yes, I already know that this confusion is already exactly the way I really want it to be. That's hitting a home run. That's hitting a home run. There's no swing and miss in that at all. And yet it's something that the least likely, you never think of saying that, would you? In your whole life, you go through your whole life, you can go through 1,000 lives, and never would it ever occur to you to say, yes, I already know that this confusion is exactly the way I really want it to be. It would never occur to you to say that. So it is the grace of God to be practicing, hearing this, and practicing like this. It absolutely is the grace of God. Which I have always prayed for, but I didn't know how it would manifest. You know, how can we know ahead of time that it's going to manifest like this? It would never occur to us that it would manifest like this. So you just have to, in phase 1, 2, and 3, people have to keep praying for the grace of God, keep believing, praying for the grace of God. But they really don't know how it's going to manifest. Because this is just like seemingly counterintuitive, you know, to our familiarity. It's counterintuitive to our familiarity for sure. When we say, yes, I already know that my hopelessness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my destitution is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my depression is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that my despair is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Now ask yourself this, in practicing this and saying this, are you really depressed? Really? Or are you actually elated? I mean, I'm elated right now. I feel elated. Wow. This is just like a miracle from God, actually. This is the grace of God, to be able to look at it this way, practice it this way. This perspective is the grace of God, powerful. Yes, I already know that this depression is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this despair is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this despondency is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this sadness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. So you might say, in the last year I was in the minor leagues, the high minor leagues of practicing, high minor leagues. Now, I'm in the major leagues. This is big league stuff. This is absolutely big league stuff. Yes, I already know that this freak out is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this suicidalness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this psychoticness is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this split-mindedness is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. So only a true teacher would suggest this sort of thing to those who are asking for help. Like Jesus, Longchampa, okay. Genuine articles. Those are the genuine articles. Only they would dare say this, practice this, this is the way to realize that you're already free, to realize you're perfect freedom, you're already perfectly free. Nothing, to realize that nothing ever happened. This is the way to realize that nothing ever happened. Okay. Practice like this to accept the fact that nothing has ever happened. Okay? To accept the fact that nothing has ever happened. Only the genuine article is going to suggest this. And keep on suggesting it, you see. I already know that this split-mindedness is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this mental illness is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this inner torment is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this deviancy is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this degradation is already exactly the way that I really want it to be. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Spirit exactly as God created me. So we're doing a little cool down here after this very intense workout we just did. Very shocking, wow. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. And I had to catch myself there, guys, starting to rock back and forth. Don't rock back and forth. Stay steady. Keep your sitting, just steady, steady. Basically steady. Don't have to not move at all, you know, but like a statue. But it can be a statue that moves a little bit, but don't rock back and forth. Yeah. Sit quietly. Don't be goofy. All right. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So I accept nothing has ever happened. I accept that nothing has ever happened. eternal spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So, I'm not slouching. I'm not being goofy. I'm sitting here steady, not slouching, not being goofy. Okay, check, check, check. Everything's fine. That's it. Check, check, check. Everything's fine. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So you see, in these practices, they're so intense. You need a fallback that you're very comfortable with. Say, oh yeah, this is my security blanket. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Now, the good part about spending your life on the spiritual path intensely is you've been there and done that, and you don't want to keep on doing it. You don't want to go back. You don't want to keep on doing it. And you say, you know what? It's time for this leap of faith. Time for phase four. And you just, there's something within you that just says, yeah. Somehow you've been set up for it. You've gotten the inner boost somehow. Yeah. Or maybe this is the inner boost that you need. Possible. But having been there and done that, you say, I don't want to keep doing that forever. No, I'm ready for success, actually. I'm ready to realize that I've already succeeded. And this is just a reenactment. I'm ready to reenact my success. I'm ready to reenact my success right now, see? This is just a reenactment. We're already. I know that I already am. I am already I am. I know I am already I am. I know I am already I am. I know I am already I am. So this is just a reenactment. You know, but we're ready for the reenactment. The rest of the stuff is really not the interest. Do I really want to read another spiritual book? You know, do I really want to read another spiritual book? Not really. You know, no, not really. So for me, now, getting in this phase four, I don't even want to read any spiritual book anymore, to tell you the truth. It pales in comparison to this practice, pales in comparison. And Jesus will be the first one to tell you. He said the purpose of, for instance, A Course in Miracles, the text especially, is to make itself unnecessary because you've gone on to the practicing. Once you go on to the practicing, then you realize the text is just stale, it's pale, stale, and wow. You realize the practicing is where it's at. That is really where it's at. So super fortunate are those who are actually practicing, because they know this is where it's at. There's no doubt. They can't be deceived anymore. You know, they can't be. Someone says, here's a self-help book. Hey, no thanks. I'm practicing. Wow. I'm walking. We're walking together in the wow. You know, here with phase four. So I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This is a common security blanket that is very helpful. We can afford to have one convention here. Probably. We'll see how it goes. But I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. This is a very totally neutral ecumenical statement, right? I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. You see, we can say this. Now, I'd like to practice like this all day. Keep practicing, but you know, it's tough for people to watch tapes. Tapes that are 8 hours long, probably. Maybe we'll do that at some point. If it's requested, maybe I'll do an 8-hour tape. Have to do it in four two-hour segments is what I'd have to do. But Yes, I can do that. I have the memory card, can handle that, and just do an 8-hour taping,
sure.
Like an 8-hour retreat. But problem is, it's too intense for that. It's too intense. 2 hours is enough intensity with this. Really. It's like a buffet table, and you say, wow, I can just sit here all day and eat. Well, after coming back 4 times, you'll probably say, I can't eat another bite. Oh, don't you want this chocolate eclair? No, I can't. Forget it. No way. So, we could do 8 hours, but right now, I think two hours is just about the right format. Maybe later, when we get really in great shape, maybe we can go 8. Yeah, why not? But first things first, getting in shape is the first. Again, run a marathon right off the bat. Getting in shape is the first. So these 2-hour sessions really give us a chance to let it sink in and start getting our wind. You know, it's like, wow, yeah, I can do this. I'm doing it. I'm already doing it. I've already succeeded at doing this. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded in doing this. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded in doing this. Wow. All this is just a reenactment, because we're honoring our creativity by reenacting this. But I know I've already succeeded in doing this. Yes, I already know I've already succeeded in doing this. Always half full. Everything's crisp for the moment. Yes, I already know this pain is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this suffering is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this conflict is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this conflict is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this wrongness is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this vileness is already exactly what I really want to experience. Yes, I already know that this unfairness is already exactly what I really want to experience. And you're practicing a few details. Don't slouch. Okay, see, don't slouch. Don't let yourself slouch. Don't get goofy. Sit quietly. Sit quietly. Don't slouch. Don't go goofy. And don't keep your hands out of contact with your body. Okay, just let the hands be contact with the hands. Okay, so the hands like this, or like this, or like this, or just. Cough. I mean, I have to clear my throat because I'm talking. But try not to cough or sneeze. Okay, just don't react. Try to not keep the hands to the hands. Hands to the hands. Okay, hands to the hands. Sit quietly. Hands to the hands. Don't slouch. Don't be goofy. Don't get goofy. Dress modestly. We're not trying to draw any attention to the body whatsoever. No attention to the body. So dress very modestly. Be severely modest. Be severely modest in your dress when you're practicing, even by yourself. Practice being severely modest in your dress. be meek, humble, self-effacing, repentant, quiet, quiet and sober, quiet and sober, calm, quiet, sober. These are just little details. Just water. A few sips of water is okay. No food, no food. Just a little water. That's it, which is what I've been doing. A little bit of water occasionally. So these are just a little details. Easy, you know, easy. Sit quiet. Sit. Be severely modest in your appearance. Severely modest in your appearance. Sit quietly, hands to hands. Don't, no slouching, and don't get goofy. Have a few sips of water if you need it. Be meek, humble, unassuming, sober, repentant. Mood of repentance, I call it. Mood of repentance. Which means this humble. Be very humble. Humble, self-effacing, meek, unassuming. Humble, unassuming, meek. This is called the mood of repentance. So, with your attitude, easy. Mood of repentance. And then try not to cough or sneeze, and don't scratch, don't itch, don't scratch the itch, whatever. Keep hands to hands, that's it. Hands to hands. Or hands to ear. Hands to ear, hands to hands, or just hands to hands, you know, just think of that. Hands to hands, oh yeah, hands to hands. Don't slouch. You know, don't just like, you know, just like this, you know, it's like, just, you know, slouching. No, we sit. No, just no slouching. Don't slouch. Don't get goofy. Like this, you goofy. Don't get goofy. Don't get goofy. That throws you off. Throws you off. The hills are alive. Whoops. Whoops. No, don't get goofy. Hey, I really love it. Whoops. Don't get goofy. When we're practicing, don't get goofy. Be serious. Be sober. Be serious, be sober. Be serious, be sober. Don't get goofy, be serious, be sober. You can go over this. We'll go over and over this for sure. Easy though, right? Easy. Mood of repentance. Sit quietly. Hands to hands. No slouching, no goofiness. Restrain, you know, your coughing and sneezing as much, you know, as much as you possibly can. Use your will to restrain it. A little bit of water if you need it. Okay. Serious, sober practice. Serious, sober practice. We'll be severely modest. Okay. Practice. Be severely modest. For those who are face force, easy. All this stuff's easy, easy. No strain, easy, no problem. Not even any concern in our mind. But occasionally we need to remind ourselves, oh yeah, okay. Be severely modest, mood of repentance, sit quietly, no slouching, don't be goofy, hands to hands, a little sip of water, it's fine, that's it. Just restrain your reactions, coughing, sneezing, you know, all this stuff. Now, sometimes it happens. For instance, I have to talk here, and my throat was having problems with my throat. So I did have to clear my throat. I could have been quiet and tried to let it go away. Maybe that's even better. But generally, in the practicing, you're doing it mentally. Or we could even do it out loud. I don't know how it'll go, but you can do it out loud or mentally. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that I'm already in light. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. In fact, I think doing it out loud is better. Oh, and eyes open. Eyes open. Eyes open. Eyes open. For the most part. You know, we're not keeping our eyes closed like this. We're not trying to keep our eyes open. If you want to like narrow them down a little bit, if you want to close them occasionally, that's fine. But for the most part, you know, the eyes, however the eyes want to be, you're not trying to keep them closed though. You know, not trying to Okay, everybody, close your eyes. I want you to imagine. No, no, we're not doing that. Because we're noticing stuff. You say, oh, that tree. Because we're practicing with our environment, what we notice. So I already know. Yes, I already know that this tree is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this sky is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this building is already exactly the way I really want it to be. But we're really not focused on the body at all, what the body's doing. We just realize just these general conventions and then, you know, forget about it. Because those who are in phase four, they're going to do it right. It's already guaranteed. It's already just reenacting the success they already have. They're reenacting it. See? Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Yes, I already know that I've already succeeded. Oh, and no music, no music, no music, no music. No singing, no music, no singing, no music. Very distracting. That's something that's a competition. The ego says, hey, you like this spiritual practicing, really? Well, you probably really love this song then. I bet you your spiritual practicing will make this song sound even better to you. You know, it's compensation. The ego's trying to lure you away. No music, no music, no singing, no music. Now for third phasers, that's very difficult because the ego often uses music and singing as compensation for not doing this practice. The ego says, well, I'll tell you what, you can't do this practice, but I'll give you something that's even better. The ego says, yeah, music and singing, he's going to love it. Well, been there, done that. It cannot compare. Cannot compare at all. So that's a bad, bad deal. Don't make any deals with the ego. So no, we don't use music or singing here. And again, the practice is so compelling. We don't even think about that. Well, who cares? Are you kidding me? I don't want a song. I want this. I want, you know, yes, I already know that this music is already exactly the way I really want it to be. It's already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I know that this singing is already exactly, yes, I already know that this singing is already exactly the way I really want it to be. Yes, I already know that this entertainment is already exactly the way I want it to be. So our surroundings, bland, again, severely modest, bland. This is great. We say, this is great. We don't want to be distracted from practicing. We don't want to be distracted from practicing. Are you kidding? This practicing is fantastic. It's wonderful. Don't want to be distracted. So yes, I already know that these distractions are already exactly the way I really want them to be. Yes, I already know that all distractions are already exactly the way I really want them to be.